I hope you guys are doing well. So today we'll do a breakdown of how to create this energy sword effect. Okay, I'm not feeling too well, so that's why I'm doing a breakdown rather than a complete tutorial. So bear with me for this one, please. So the first thing you need to do is download this royalty-free sword. The link will be in the description below in the video. So you can download this sword or any other sword. It's completely free to download. So the next step is to import it in Blender. So when you import it, go into edit mode and you'll see that you can actually, it's actually divided into parts. So when you click on L, you can actually select different parts of it and assign materials. Now I have this part selected, I can actually still assign it with different materials, you know. So different parts, like this has rope attached to it, or maybe the handle is different, or maybe this blade part is different. So you can actually give a lot of different materials like I have over here. So they're not anything special, just basic materials. So yeah, so the next thing you need to do is import an empty, add in an empty, shift A to add in an empty. Okay, then access, and then you can add in a light, like some light I have added it, and then you need to add in a sphere. Then go into edit mode and subdivide it by a lot. Okay, and after that you need to add in a displacement modifier, set the strength to 0.5, change the texture coordinate into object, and then give it a texture and give it a noise texture. Okay, and then the object should be the empty, and the strength is 0.5, so you will get this sort of spiky ball kind of look. And after that we need to make the material. So let's go into the shader editor. Okay, the material is basically in the material output we have a mix shader, and before I forget, the blend mode should be alpha clip and also turn on bloom. So the material output is connected with a mix shader. The mix shader is connected with a transparent BSCF on the lower side. On the upper side it's another mix shader, and on the top side in a factor we have a color ramp that has constant at its setting. By default it's linear but changes to constant, and also add in our noise texture with the color ramp. Plug in the factor to the factor, and the settings don't need to be changed. So the second mix shader is connected with another color ramp, which is linear and really up close like this. You can actually change this if to your liking, but just keep it up close for now, and add in an emission shader on the top half with any color you want. I actually have yellow lightning, so I'll go with that, and strength to 10, and also a transparent BSCF on the lower side of the mix shader. On the top half of the color ramps, add in a math node, shift A. Math, everything can be added like by clicking shift A and then searching it, math mode, and then change add to subtract. Okay, this way you can get this node, and connect that math node with two Voronois. The Voronois have to be same. Okay, the randomized, both of them have one randomized exponent 0.5. This scale should be also same all the time for this to work. So add in a value node and give it a value of 3 or other value depending on how you want it. They're both Mioski F2 and 3D, and they're both vector connected with the mapping mode, and the mapping mode is connected with texture coordinate to object, and the object is the same empty we connected with the same empty that we connected with the texture displacement modifier. So once that's done, the empty now controls the displacement of this sphere, and it also controls the material as well. So the empty, you can add keyframes on frame 1, or add a keyframe I on its rotation on all x, y, z axis, and on it as well as on its scale. And then on any other frame 60, I added it on 60, you can change it on different frames and add in another keyframe by clicking I to add another keyframe and change the values. It's the scale is small, the rotation is also changed, and then on another frame you can also change the scale of the empty, which will also which will in turn also change the scale of the emission here, the shader, and the displacement modifier as well, and then also the rotation of the shader. So let me just play it for you. Okay, you can see that it's changing along with the empty. So this lighting shader can be used for a lot of other things as well. You can use it for lightning strikes, but you have to tweak it a little bit. So I'm just going to give you the final look of the shader, just in case you didn't understand. So I hope you guys learned something great. Please leave a like, subscribe to our channel. I'll keep making water trails. So see you next time. Goodbye.